With rumours swirling, Nationals leader Michael McCormack could be challenged in a party room meeting tomorrow.
Well, these are matters for the National Party.
The Foreign Minister did her best to sidestep the issue this morning.
I'm not going to make personal comments or observations on my parliamentary colleagues and I'm not going to inject myself into the National Party's process.
A story in yesterday's AFR suggesting Barnaby Joyce has the numbers to win a leadership spill, a distraction for the government. The PM quarantining after his G7 trip, Michael McCormack dismissed yesterday's reports with this statement to 10 News First. If others think that they should be talking about themselves and their ambitions at this difficult and challenging time, then that's a matter for them. I'm concentrating on the issues that matter to ordinary, everyday Australians. 10 News First understands if a spill motion is successful, Deputy Leader David Littleproud would run against Barnaby Joyce, but only if Michael McCormack dropped out. But Nationals I've spoken to doubt that Barnaby Joyce supporters even have the 12 votes they need in the party room to force a leadership vote.
While farmers throughout Australia are dealing with a mice plague, there's a plague of disloyalty in the National Party.
Tensions within the junior coalition partner flared last week as the acting PM strutted his stuff in question time.
I would much sooner live in Australia than anywhere else in the nation.
And when senior National Keith Pitt indicated he didn't think his party would support a net zero emissions target.
How do you judge the mood in your party room now on this?
Well, I think they'd be unsupportive.
Not the line Maurice Payne was running today.
It is the broad position of the Australian government that we want to achieve net zero emissions as soon as possible and preferably by 2050.
Really?
And that's the government's position.
That is absolutely what the Prime Minister has said.
The Prime Minister might have said it, but the Nationals don't want it. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.